Welcome to MTA Queensland's industry newsletter. This week we're trying a different approach. We know that members are on the run, they're very busy. So this week we're going to walk you through the key pieces of information that are in the newsletter. So if you are pushed for time, just have a quick look at the video and you'll be able to extract what you need. It's also a joint approach this week. Yes, unfortunately you'll hear from me, but in the background you'll also hear from Jade, one of our key people in our marketing department, just to help us work through all of the information. Now the first piece of information that I want you to be aware of is we've got an updated consolidated wages guide. So if you have downloaded or accessed the wages guide over the last couple of weeks, please download the latest version. There are some adjustments and I really want you to make sure you're working off the right document. Again, on the workplace relations front is the gift that keeps giving. COVID-19 continues to impact not only on our industry, but across the state and across the nation. So if you have employees, generally casual in nature, who are forced to have COVID leave or work from home or are unable to earn money because of COVID, the federal government, in collaboration with the states, has reintroduced the pandemic leave payment. It's a payment of up to $750. So certainly have a look at the newsletter if you have employees that might be interested in that.
So Rod, are there any new resources for businesses to improve their online presence in this week's industry bulletin?
It's a great question, Jade. As I move across the state, I hear from members about just the sheer effort that's required to get across the latest digital tools and technology and keep their business in front of the curve. Really pleased to announce that the Queensland Government's released a plethora of online tools that small business can use in upgrading their digital presence. It's just a click away in the newsletter.
So our new Motor Trader recently came out. Who was this month's MTA Q&A on?
Really excited about that. Small business continues to be a major feature, not just of our membership, but if you look at the Queensland economy, over 85% of businesses in the Queensland economy are small. This week, Ian Payne Automotive, a father and son team, his son Nicholas, feature in the magazine. And it's really, really pleasing to be able to engage with people who are making a huge difference in their communities through the operation of small business. It's genuinely worth a read.
And finally, what is MTA Queensland doing to attract more workers to our industry?
Won't be a shock to anyone. Everyone's saying it's not just a skill shortage now, it's a genuine people shortage. So our industry is in competition with all of the others. We've introduced AutoReady. We've talked about it a couple of times before, but we are now running school-based programs across Queensland, a five-day program, you know, engaging with years 10, 11 and 12 cohorts, exposing them to the fantastic careers that are available now, but also into the future as technology changes, for example, around electric vehicles. A real opportunity, if you're an employer and you see AutoReady's operating around one of your schools, let us know, because in the process we'll be able to identify young people who are interested in a career or might even be interested in a school-based apprenticeship. See you next week.